Say if like we're somewhere like in a lift and there's like a voice in the lift and my mate will be like, mate, that's real. That's not in your head. And I love that sort of stuff.
First time I got sectioned in 2012, they labelled it manic depression. The second two times, I was like, no, this is like paranoid schizophrenia. Mm. Explaining it is difficult though. They will have to like see me when I'm having an episode, if that makes sense.
When I get psychotic, I'm like, I think I'm being watched by everyone I'm so paranoid. Do you get any sort of delusions? Man, I've been delusional about like thinking I'm the Messiah.
Yeah.
You know Nina Simone? I thought I was like a sort of reincarnation of Nina Simone.
I live in a block, like a block of flats, and I live on the second floor, which is pretty high. I started hearing voices that someone was talking to me outside. So I looked outside my window and like, luckily I didn't do nothing stupid, but like I went downstairs to the person's car, went to the window to say something, and the person looked at me like, what are you doing at my window? And then at that moment, I just like, kind of caught myself and then went back upstairs. And by the time I went back upstairs, all my mum and my family was there. And
my best mate like was with me, and I was like, suddenly I thought he was against me. I thought he was part of this like film crew. I thought he was an actor. I thought I was so like, just basically accusing him of all this stuff. I really believe that he was not who he said he was. Like, even though he's my best friend, I know him so well, I spend all the time with him. It's like my mind just switched and reality like, rationale just sort of goes out the window and it's horrible. Mm-hmm. When I'm psychotic, it's like I'm trapped. If I don't say these things, bad things will happen. Mm-hmm. And I've got to like walk in certain ways and like, I can't stop myself.
So I never thought I'll be able to function again in society.
Am I
gonna be able to go on stage again?
Everything that I wanted to do in life and like my dreams, ambitions, sort of just, out the window. I thought I was going to be in hospital, like, sort of...
All the time.
But
in reality, it's manageable.
How do you manage it?
I'm still on medication. I couldn't sleep.
At the beginning, like, I was really, like, sort of anti-medication.
I
used to fight against it. I didn't want medication. I didn't want therapy. Yeah. Like, I just wanted everyone to leave me alone, to be honest. But now I'm like, do you know what? This is what I've got. This is what I am. And I think that kind of acceptance is, like...
Definitely.
A massive part of it.
100%. The only thing that's really difficult for me is my parents. The background I'm from, like African background, like they don't, this is like a taboo subject. Like, my mum's a private person. I'm like on Instagram sharing my business and like doing TED Talks and doing all this stuff. Like my mum thinks that, like, where did he come from?
So I'm from a Jewish family and it's the same. I was the only one that started like sort of talking about it, and everyone was like, why do you want to share that? I had to start like talking about it. Like,
totally relate.
It's the worst thing to just kind of have to keep hiding it, keep putting a mask on, and I just got so tired of putting a mask on, and you just got to be, open. Now I'm just like, I call my dad up even, and I'm just like, Dad, like, I'm really not well. And like, I've never used to do that. And he gets it now. It's so different now that I'm so, open.
Every time I'd be around my friends, I felt like the first thing they're waiting for is me to start acting crazy.
Yeah, I know what you mean. If I'm with them and like, I go quiet.
So if you're not saying anything, it's like, yo,
you
good?
Yeah, my mates would be like, well, what's wrong? Like, you've been quiet for like 40 minutes, like,
I was kind of lucky a little bit that I had friends that's like really dumb. Not dumb as in like mentality, IQ, but I mean like in the way we behave, we laugh about everything.
Yeah.
Like the first time I came out of hospital and my friend saw me, the first thing he said to me was, you still in there, mate?
Say if like we're somewhere like in a lift and there's like a voice in the lift and my mate will be like, mate, that's real. Yeah. That's not in your head. And I love that sort of stuff. Take the piss out of me, like, do you know what I mean? Like, because we need to laugh about it.
We laughed about it, so that's a good thing. I feel like most people that are in the situation we have, they don't have
that. Yeah, you're right.
So it's even more intense for them.
For me, it was, how am I going to fit in? How am I going to tell everyone? Yeah. Like, because I always worry about how people judge me, do you know what I mean? The fact of being in hospital, the fact of being sectioned, the fact that I've got this diagnosis, like, and I was 20, I was like, what the fuck? Who's gonna wanna be around me now? Cause I've got this, been through this. I wish I wouldn't have hidden away all those sort of years, like from everyone, like trying to sort of, isolate myself, thinking it was the best thing for me, thinking it was the best thing for everyone. I just thought I could never like have a normal sort of even like conversation, do you know what I mean? With like people around me, cause I had this thing now. And finally I started like actually going to my friends and trying to, you know, be open about it.
Nah, it's hard articulating this kind of stuff, man.
A therapist would say to me, oh, but you need to accept yourself. You need to learn to love yourself. I was like, I can't do that. Do you know what I mean? Like, I fucking hate myself. Yeah. But like, it does, it changes. You can change it. Like, you think you can't, but...
You can. The reason why people get like so anxious when they think about it is because they want to do it in one day.
I know, this is it.
So they're thinking like, I need to love myself today. And then when they think about how difficult that process is, it overwhelms them. It's like gym, getting big. You know you're not going to get big in 24 hours.
Exactly.
I've got a quote in my phone that says, most of the things you worry about won't happen. I'll say to anyone that's just getting diagnosed, like, if you can repeat that mantra in your head, it'll really help. Because most of the things you worry about don't end up happening. They really don't.